Hi, everyone. Welcome to the 43rd Head of the Charles Regatta. I'm Jimmy Young. You know, you can't always count on the World Series coming to Boston in October, but you can count on the world's greatest rowers showing up for the Head of the Charles. It's become the world's largest rowing regatta, and over 8,200 rowers are here to take part from 17 countries. Over 250,000 spectators will line the banks of the Charles River, but you know, it didn't start that way.
Back in 1965, a couple of hardcore rowers at the Cambridge Boat Club decided to stage a race. Taking their inspiration from classic English competitions, they decided to call it the Head of the Charles.
It had humble beginnings. It started by members of the Cambridge Boat Club. There were fewer than 100 single shells the very first year, and it caught on quite quickly because it was a concept borrowed from Great Britain, the Head of the River race. And the Charles is a unique body of water with challenging bridges and twisting turns, which makes it a more exciting racing venue.
Back then, nobody knew it, but all the elements were in place to make this fledgling Head of the Charles Regatta the world's biggest and best rowing race.
We were quite convinced it wouldn't work, actually. It was a funny time of year to be having a rowing regatta. It was a strange type of regatta where people wouldn't know who was ahead and who was behind. But clearly, the emphasis is on fun, and it's a fun thing to row in, it's a fun thing to work on, and it's clearly become a fun thing to come and watch.
But it hasn't always been easy. The Head of the Charles is always subject to that most famous of New England phenomena, fall weather.
We have made the decision to cancel the remaining events for the 1996 Head of the Charles Regatta.
The regatta rebounded nicely from its only cancellation to continue its incredible upward trajectory. Now, the Head of the Charles hosts more rowers from more different places than any race in the world.
Yeah, you know, I've been hacking around rowing for 20-some-odd years off and on. Never had a chance to row in the Charles, so when someone says, "Yeah, have you been there, do you want to do it?" It's like, yeah, of course, I'd love to.
I think it's really awesome. It's so amazing just to see so many people and all different types of rowers and just a whole bunch of different people. It's really awesome to see.
I heard an awful lot about it coming in. Pretty excited about just the crowds and all the extra events they have set up for us, and just the number of boats on the water trying to get through these bridges.
The regatta's reputation and legacy is obviously well established with both competitors and spectators, but there is no doubt that the future is even brighter.
All right, so why do 250,000 people come to Boston every October to watch the Head of the Charles? Quite simply, this is great sports entertainment. This is head-style racing as opposed to Olympic-style racing. In Olympics, they line the boats up one by one, and it's the first boat to the finish line wins. In head-style racing, they start boats at 10 to 15-second intervals, and the boat that finishes the course in the fastest time wins the Head of the Charles.
Three, two, one, mark!
It's hard. The Head of a Charles is a different race. It's very tricky with a very windy and longer course to what we're used to racing an Olympic distance. And you know, it's a time trial event rather than a head-to-head race.
The race covers 3 miles, starting at the BU Boathouse, and winds through a number of sharp turns and under 7 bridges, which makes this course one of the most challenging in the world.
The course is very challenging, and there are a lot of competitors in the event, and so that makes for some hair-raising moments.
Collisions are commonplace, but that's all part of what makes the Head of the Charles so special for rowers and spectators.
Mind your turn, yellow boat, mind your turn!
All boats are electronically timed at several points along the race in a precise chronology that leaves no room for error.
We use photo finish cameras at the start and the finish. We use those to capture a time of day that they cross the finish line or the start line. That gets sent out on the internet to a server. When they cross the finish line, they do the same thing. That gets sent to the server. The server does the math, and the results get published on the internet in real time.
It's only after all the boats have crossed the finish line and the times tabulated that each crew knows whether they truly are the Head of the Charles.
When we come back, we'll take a look at the 3-time world single scull champion, Mahi Drysdale from New Zealand. Plus, we'll find out just how this whole huge event comes together as the Head of the Charles Regatta continues after this.
Drive the sporty, fuel-efficient Audi A4. Visit your local Audi dealer today.